Hello everyone! Exit or not exit, or break even, is a question that you always want to ask yourself. So that is today's topic for this video. So thank you for watching and thank you for joining on this YouTube video session. My name is Kei and I am a professional Japanese forex trader full-time here in Tokyo, Japan. So today is the 27th of January on Wednesday and I see pound pairs spiking. And also AUD pairs are also spiking and I was buying the pound yen and I exit with the break even. So let me show you how I've exited the break even, which is the topic for today. So before starting here, just a quick disclaimer. This information is basically based on my experience and knowledge. So when you take trades, please do within risk. So here's a pound yen and I was seeing 4-hour chart today. As it was moving up this way, I saw the Kijun Sen up and also the Kumo was moving up when I was looking at the chart a couple of hours ago. And I saw this uptrend, so I was looking for the buy chance on this candlestick over here. And I was seeing the 1-hour chart. It confirmed the uptrend in 1-hour chart also somewhere over here. As I see the Kijun Sen up and also Kumo was also moving up. And then I went to the 5-minute chart. And I got 3 confirmations and took a buy. So let me switch it to the MT5, the trading platform that I use, so that I can see the exactly where I bought it and exactly where I exited. Alright, there you go. So here is the MT5 and you can you see this small arrow pointing up? Hold on, let me enlarge. Alright, so here is or exactly where I took a buy. I got this Fibonacci bounce and the band walking, kind of trend line breakout, and also stochastics overlapping with gold cross. And at the breakout, I took a buy over here. And I was expecting the market goes up this way continuously, but it was consolidating. It went flat actually, and also in with P wave. So after I took a buy over here, my stop loss was previous low, so it was over here. I was putting the stop loss over here and I kept holding this buy expecting the market goes up this way. And next time I watched the market, I was watching over here. So I was actually away, I'm actually outside from my home when I took a buy. And I was looking at the chart from mobile sometimes at times, but when I see the market, you know, I saw the market over here somewhere. I thought it was gonna go up still, and next time I saw the market from mobile, I was like over here. So I saw this reversal like N wave, but afterwards I confirmed there was like a, you know, support over here and it goes up on this N wave as my expectation. So I kept holding this buy, and the next timing that I saw the mobile was like over here. So after I see this mobile, the market kept going up this way on N wave and consolidate over here. So when I saw it over here, I thought it's gonna go up still because higher time frames were still moving up. So I was expecting the market goes up this way, but the last time I saw the mobile a couple of minutes ago was exactly over here. So it went up and down and the market is consolidating in the P wave in 5-minute chart I found. Here is a P wave and 5-minute chart. And also I saw the Bollinger Band was squeezing all in the P wave. And also over here I saw a 4-hour chart was already flat and the one was also flat. So initially when I took a buy over here, the 4 was uptrending and also 1 also uptrending, and that's why I took a buy. But as I saw the market lastly here, I see the 4-hour chart became flat and 1 became flat also. So this is exactly when I look for the exit timing over here. So after the squeeze in P wave, I was curious that the market goes spiked down this way also. I mean, it might have been going up too. But the chance for the market goes up and down was almost 50-50. Because I saw higher time frame of flat by Ichimoku. So And like I said before, I never take tries on a 50-50 chance. Whenever it becomes 60 or 40% of winning rate, or the, you know, the potential market direction to my favor, I always keep trading. But here, because the higher time frames were flat, because the chance became 50-50, I decided to exit, so that you know, after this P wave expansion, it might be going down and I might get the stop loss. So, and also over here was break even exactly. I took a buy over here and I see the P wave squeezing, and I figured the position was exactly the break even, and that's why I decided to exit with the break even over here, so that I can prepare for the downtrend afterwards on this lower time frame. And exactly did, right? It exactly did. After the Bollinger Band expansion, the market went down sharply, down like 25 pips in like 15 minutes, and also stochastic went dead cross also. So it was the right decision that I exited. So and even the market goes up this way, even the market have been going up this way and renews higher this way, then I can re-enter the market to buy. But now it's going down, so I don't look for any buy chance at the moment. Although I see gold cross stochastics in 5 and also some kind of retracement over here, I won't take a buy, because now in entire time frames it's flat. Here is in 4-hour chart. Once again, GJ it's flat, you see Kumo flat, Kijun Sen flat, and also 1-hour chart, I see this is uptrending in 1, so, and also the Kijun Sen is moving up, so that there is a good chance the market has been supported by this Kijun Sen and goes up this way. But still, I don't take a buy, because higher time frames, 4-hour chart is flat, and also daily chart also becomes, oh, now this is uptrending, so I can still look for the buy chance. But yeah, in if 4-hour chart is flat now, so I don't take trade in 4-hour chart basis. So I look at the daily chart to be uptrending, and also 1-hour chart is also uptrending now, so I still look for the buy chance in lower time frames. But as per today's topic, this is exactly how I exit with the break-even line over here, because my intention is not to lose. Right, not to lose, I think in that sense is more important than winning, the winning profit, because break even is very difficult. You know, if you think about it, psychologically speaking, if you see the P wave over here, and especially when you buy over here, and if you see higher time frames still uptrending, then you can expect the market goes up still, and that will be the hope, because originally you took a buy. You know, originally you believed, or you were confident that the market goes up this way. But after you see the market situation changes, as you analyzed originally, then you have to change your mindset to exit. Exactly what would be the exit timing, or where can you, where can I exit with the break even, is the next question you want to ask yourself. Otherwise, you get lost like this when the big spike comes down on the market. So this is the risk management, and this is the part of the psychological management as well. Because markets move in 24 hours almost, and it moves every day, except Saturday and Sunday it goes every day. So you can always look for the next chance, right, tomorrow, or you can look for the next chance on other pair. So the important thing is that the chance is everywhere, every day. So better to wait for the chance, and if the market doesn't go towards your favor, then you have to exit, is my opinion. So that's why I say that my goal for this YouTube channel is not to win, but actually help you become a non-losing trader. Because if you don't lose, if you can you know, take trades like this way in the break evens, then eventually you should be running profit, because every time you take trades, you are following the major trend direction. So break-evens are okay. Break-evens, small drawdowns are okay, as long as you are following the major trend direction, is my strategy. And that's exactly what I teach on this YouTube channel, and what I try to explain on this YouTube channel every day. So I hope you liked today's video. If you liked it, please press a good button and please subscribe and click the bell so that you get notified as we keep explaining these things on this YouTube channel every day in different topics. So one last note is that the GTS, the Global Trading School, is my hands-on teaching up to 5 members only for 3 months. And the next one is going to be from April, May, June, and this is fitting soon. Actually, we've got only 2 members still on the seat. So please, if you're interested, please click on the link below the description and you can see the details of what I teach on this GTS class. And if you're interested, please write me an email. Please contact me through the contact form by email so that you know, I can put you on the members list. Alright, so thank you for joining and thank you for watching until the end. So I hope you're catching some trends this week. Lastly, I see the currency strength chart today. USD is quite strong. The orange one, USD, is quite strong, and AUD is very weak now. So watch out, these USD and AUD pairs are there, so volatile today. Alright, so once again, thank you for watching until the end, and I hope to see you on the next one. So until I see you then, please stay healthy and stay gold. Bye for now. Matane. Matane means see you soon. Matane. Bye for now.